Virgin Radio, The Chris Fade Show. Ladies and gentlemen, in studio, Martin Garrix! You, I mean, I already loved you, but I love you a little bit more, man. That was what a gentleman you are, mate. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
How cool. So welcome back to Dubai.
Thank you.
You love it?
I'm so happy.
It's so good.
Yeah, it's crazy. I'm here now 8 days. So I can relax a little bit, do some sightseeing, some work, do an interview with you guys.
Which is so cool. I mean, Saturday night's going to be a huge night as well. Atlantis Live, headline by the one and only Martin Garrix. We love when you perform because you really, truly, not only with your music, but with yourself, you bring the energy, man. So it's going to be an exciting show here at the Atlantis.
Very much so. I saw the venue yesterday and it's crazy. They're building this mega structure. It's beautiful because when they proposed it, they didn't build it yet, so they only showed renders. And sometimes you see renders, you're like, yeah, sure, it's gonna look like that. But actually, yesterday I was there at the site. I was like, oh my god, this is crazy.
Mm-hmm. Is it hard to blow Martin Garrix away anymore? Like you've seen so much. How do we impress you when it comes to a stage? And do you have a say in what you want, or is it presented to you by a bunch of creatives? Is it like, this is what we want to do?
No, it's all collaborative effort. And the Atlantis Live team, they've been amazing. And together with my team, they basically sketched out ideas and designed the best stage that we think could do a good show on.
All right, Platinum List, got your tickets. There are still only a minimal amount, but get there, Atlantis. It's going to be there, Atlantis Live, with the one and only Martin Garrix. So you've built a studio in your hotel room now.
It's not a crazy studio. It's just two speakers and a sound card, and then I plug my laptop in so I can.
So what are you doing? What are you creating right now?
So last week I've been recording vocals all week, a bunch of different songs, and then I take the vocals with me. But imagine we do like 50 takes. So then what I'm doing this week is word per word. I'm going to go through each take and see which word sounds the best, which syllable, and then I make like one comp, like one final vocal.
You do it word for word?
Yeah, but I enjoy it a lot. It takes a lot of time, but I want singers to hear them back and be like, what?
How did you do that?
Yeah.
But with your career right now, obviously, you're Martin Garrix. If you didn't want to have to work again in your life, you wouldn't have to. If you didn't want to have to create any more music, you don't have to. So this is for you as passion. It's from the heart. It's what you love doing. No matter what happens, you will always do this.
100%. I cannot imagine my life without music, without creating music, without listening to music, without playing music. I get so much joy from music in general, which is, I cannot imagine my life without music.
It's crazy because you have that feeling, and then for someone like us who listens to the music that you create, we have the same feeling, you know? And it's true. There's something about what you create. You create the euphoric sound, but you create the, you want to go out.
Memories as well. Yeah, I remember dancing to your Dua Lipa song as well with my wife last time you were here. And I can remember that forever. You know what I mean? So amazing. It's great.
And for people that don't know, Martin Garrix, you started young, man. How young were you when you were doing it all?
I started making music when I was like 11. And then around a few years before, I was playing guitar. So I would write songs on a guitar. I started messing around with like a little DJ set. And then when I was 14, 15, I got signed. And then when I was 16, then Animals came. And then suddenly, it's 11 years ago. It's kind of crazy.
All right, Martin Garrix hanging out with us. He's going to be at the Atlantis Live. It's Atlantis the Palm. Tickets still available Saturday night. You just mentioned Animals. I'm going to play it right now. Take me back to that moment. 16-year-old Martin Garrix creating the song Animals, which today is still in rotation on most radio stations across the globe.
Wow. It was crazy. I was making music in my bedroom at my parents' house, like the house where I grew up in. And I had two simple speakers. Like I think the cost of my studio there was maybe 300 euros. It was so it was so limited. And but I think it's cool also because sometimes if you don't have all the gear, you have to be creative with what you have. I remember making this melody and I was like, the same night I was in bed, I was like, wow, this is sketchy, I should do something with it. And then I did the drop idea, and I was not confident about it. So I was sending it around to, like, Chesto was one of the first persons who I sent it to.
Like, hold on, 16 years old, and you're sending it to Tiesto.
He mentored me. Like, before Animals, I released a song on his label, and he added me on Skype. And I remember, like, first time I met him, I was like shaking. I was walking through the house with my laptop in my hand. And
did mum and dad know who Tiesto was?
Yeah.
Oh, they were a part of his journey.
Yeah.
Chesto, legend. But in 2004, he performed at the Olympics in Greece. He did the ceremony. And I remember my mom dragging me in front of the TV, like, you have to see this.
Cool.
And for me, that left such a, because you saw, like, ministers, royal family, so everybody like danced to songs that didn't even have lyrics, and I was like, that's powerful.
So then obviously you did, you say you sent Animals to Tiesto, did he hear it?
And he's been mentoring me ever since.
Like, and did he give it the stamp of it when he heard it? He just went,
he actually gave me some feedback. He was like, because I had a whole different second section, he was like, just take that out, it's too much info, like the main part is the I was like, the main focus should be on that. You shouldn't have two different drops. And I was like, because I didn't play crazy big shows yet. And then he started playing it, and then I would look up videos on YouTube from him playing the song. So it was like, it was crazy. And then I would go back in the studio, like, try and make new stuff.
Did you have to get like special approval to play your gigs because you were like under the age of 18 and stuff?
In the Netherlands, it's all pretty chill, but then I had to go and do like shows in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
And there, everything is strict 21 plus. Yeah. And I was 17, so they would start my intro, bring me into the club, and then like I would play my outro, and they would escort me out with security because I was not allowed to be in the club.
That is so cool, man.
Awesome.
All right.
It's not cool because I could not party. I was like, thanks, Marty.
And if we go through your catalog, I don't think I can pick, that was this many years ago. Everything feels so fresh.
Thank you.
This year, though, I know, as you said, you're going to be working on new music. What do fans expect to hear from you this year?
Collabs.
Yeah, give us some names. Come on.
So I did Ultra in Miami, and I always use Ultra to premiere a lot of new music. So I premiered six new songs there.
Wow.
And I premiered my new single there, which I delivered the master to the label yesterday.
Oh my gosh.
So it has a Dubai stamp on it. It's called Wherever You Are. It's with Sean Ferrugia. I'll send it to you guys.
Wow.
Oh gosh.
Well, nice.
This is the world premiere.
Are we really going to do a world premiere right now? Can we do this?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Oh my gosh. This is great. Just keep. Not only did he was in his hotel room 30 minutes ago. He's come over here to the Virgin Radio Studios, and now we're going to get a world premiere of Martin Garrix's new single. This is unbelievable.
This is what people like from the Netherlands. They're so chilled. They're so chilled. It's amazing.
I love this. So now we've got Martin Garrix sending his new single, world premiere, to Rossi's laptop. Rossi, do not sell this, okay? Like, you know, he's from Liverpool. We've got to watch out for him, okay?
You never know.
Okay,
it's in, man. All right.
Making music is fun. It should be fun. It should not be overthinking everything in the studio. We do overthink a lot, but there's a lot of like running around, jumping around. And this song was just pure joy. Joy to make.
When you make these songs as well, do you imagine what the crowd are going to react like, obviously, definitely, to these? Yeah, because you can just imagine to that song thousands of people bouncing up and down, right?
Yeah, definitely. It's I want it to be my new show outro for the next basically the coming tour. So we now have like the team already syncing fireworks through, like, it's like I'll work on the music, then I send it to the creative team. They work on like the visuals, then we send it to the production team who work on like the fireworks show. So it's the song is in the system now, and everybody's working on making it the best experience live.
Will we hear it live on Saturday?
100%.
Okay. Yeah. What do you do when you're not making music and hanging out with friends? What does Martin Garrix do to be, I don't know, quote unquote normal? I don't know.
I like spending time with family, with my sister. In Amsterdam, when the weather is nice, I have a little canal boat. Small boat, but it's nice to, like, you can just go on the canals,
Yeah. Enjoy.
Like it's like life in Amsterdam is very, very relaxed.
I mean, yeah, it's a beautiful, apart from the stereotype of what Amsterdam is, it is just such a beautiful city. That is, you know what always got me thinking? You've got the bikes, you've got the cars, you've got the buses, the trams, but it all works.
It's absolute chaos, yeah. But somehow there's just still a little bit of flow and somehow it works.
I want to bring Nala in. Nala, yes. This is Nala, who works on our show. She's behind the scenes a lot, but she's on the scenes a lot. She's a huge fan of Martin Garrix. Also a huge fan of F1.
Yes.
And
amazing.
And she's our F1 reporter. She goes to the Abu Dhabi F1 Grand Prix for us, and she does everything and whatever. Now, the broken nose. Is that what we want to know here?
Yes. So you were partying with Lando before he won his race. Yeah. And everyone's wondering what happened to his nose, and I just want to know the story behind it.
So it's kind of a buzzkill because everybody made it crazier than it was. There was a glass that was broken on the top on the boat, and we were like partying, having a good time, and he takes a sip from the glass, and the upper half gave him a little cut in the nose.
Oh.
But because of the spot, it was bleeding a lot.
They
thought I broke his nose or something, which is not what happened. And then we had Band-Aid to put on the nose, but then very quickly he turned into a mummy. And then someone took a photo, and that photo went viral. So there's McLaren, everybody sees this picture, thinking the whole world sees this photo, thinking it's crazy bad. But luckily it was only a little scratch.
Oh my gosh. He went on to win the race.
Yeah, they said you're good luck, so.
So we would like you on the next race, if you could cut his nose again, maybe it will happen. But that's pretty cool. How did you become friends with Max and Lando? How does all that happen?
Max and I, we grew up together. I've known him for, I think, 10 years now. Long time. And then I met Lando via Max. And Lando came to one of my shows in Ibiza. And there was instant connection. We very much had the same interests and the same excitement for life. And he won his first race on Sunday. So I'm
so cool.
I got emotional. I was finally. Oh,
because they're friends, but they're family as well, right?
Yeah, and they work so hard because it's racing is it's such a, even Max in his free time, all he does is sim racing.
Oh, when he's not racing, he's actually he's in the simulator just to keep going.
Yeah, and he's doing live streams. To me, it's mind blowing, and it's such a such a strong focus, and a lot of respect for their mentality and their focus.
Do you want to pass a message on Nala to Max Orlando?
Martin, I love them.
Martin Garrix can do this for me.
I will tell them.
Huge fan. They're killing it. I was very emotional seeing Lando win because it's been a long time coming. So I was very happy about that. And I just,
that's it.
That's it.
Amazing.
So cute. All right, before we get you going, we're going to do this blind test, guys. Explain how it works, Pretty Molly.
So we're doing the Martin Garrix blind rankings right now. We have five songs. It was very hard to just pick five songs from your catalog. You have no idea what those five songs are.
No.
You're going to hear a song one by one. You have to rank them blindly, one through five. So you're going to hear a song, one through five. Where do you want to put it in there? One being the... Cool. Best five on the blow.
But you don't know what order we got them in.
No, I don't even know what songs you're going to do.
Yeah, exactly. But you just have to put them in an order, through five.
Cool. I've produced myself a very big intro here. Let me just... Martin Garrix! Blind music test.
Blind rankings. Get the name right.
I got it wrong. All right, we'll just roll with it. Here we go. Song number one from Martin Garrix. Martin Garrix, our show.
This song, I think, number four.
Number four.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. Do you remember putting, when you're doing a song with Usher, for example, are you in the studio together? Yeah. Or is he just, you're in the studio together?
We were in the studio together, and I just remember pinching myself. I was like, what's happening?
Got Usher.
But this song is already, for me, this also feels like 10 years ago. It's probably seven, but... And then he joined me on stage at Ultra Miami to perform it live. And it was just one of those moments that felt so surreal.
So cool, man.
But he's an absolute class act legend, so it was an honor to work with him.
Awesome. All right, so we put that in at number four. Yeah. That's called Don't Look Down, Martin Garrix, yeah. Usher. We've locked that in at number four. Mm-hmm. Here's your next blind song. Here we go.
Three.
Yeah. Oh. Okay.
Okay.
Now, this became one of the biggest hits of that year. Did you know it was going to do it?
No. For me, I love making music, but once you finish a song, it's not like it's out there, and then it's up to the world how they receive it, you know. Mm-hmm. But this song is done very well. It's still one of the bigger moments in the shows. Everybody sings along the hook, and it's fun. And Bibi, I love her. She's incredible, amazing voice, and she's always fun to be around.
All right, we've locked that in at number three. That was number three. Yeah. I'm putting me in order. Here we go. The next blind test. Good luck here, Martin Garrix. Your next song that we're playing for you is with an artist called...
Which ones are you going to play? It's tricky. It's tricky.
It's exactly why we're doing it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Don't be offended. They won't be offended. It's okay.
I think number two then.
Okay.
Okay. Yes. All right. Where Macklemore set to perform here in Dubai
in about
3 months. He's another talented individual, isn't he?
He's crazy. And I remember because I sent him the song and I was like, hey, man, I hear... a rap verse, like a rap section here, and I had the hook already written, the summer day section, and he sent me back like 5 minutes of freestyle. And I was like,
wow,
this is incredible. So instead of giving me just one verse, he gave me so many options, so pieced together like a crazy puzzle. And I remember he because we were on FaceTime and he showed me like his driveway. There was a crazy amount of snow, and then he played me what he did, and I just have such a visual memory of the snow, him hearing like the verse on the song, and I was like, this is sick.
So cool.
It was really fun, and we performed the song together as well on stage, and he's amazing energy.
Love it. All right, we've got that locked in at number two. So we've got Summer Days, number two. We've got In the Name of Love, number three.
Yep.
Don't Look Down in at number four. Here is your next song, though. See, for the regular person, we'd be like, oh, that's number one. But for you, Martin Garrix, it may have a different type of feeling.
No, I love the song, and I love what it did for me, but I've heard this song so many times.
Yeah, that's what I mean. That's what I mean, you know?
So you got one or five. That's all you got left to pick from.
I think this is five.
Oh!
But purely based on the fact that I've heard this song so many times. Okay. And imagine, like, whenever I'm in the studio, I hear a song on repeat.
Yeah. It's
for like the wherever you are, the final hour spent on in the project file said, I think 140 hours. So that's like,
oh my gosh, you're hearing it. Yeah.
Yeah, and that's not even when you write it. That's when you record it. You're just sound design and structure. So, Animals was. Yeah, I've heard it many times.
You don't have to justify it. We get it.
That's fine.
Okay, good. Do you look back at the songs like that one of your first ones, and think you would have done anything differently when you produced it? No.
I'm pretty good with it. The moment I deliver a song, I deliver the final master, I have peace with it. Yeah. Because I cannot, like, I can change something for the live version that I play. Like, for example, Summer Days, I play 2-3 BPM quicker. But it's not like major changes. I'm like, oh, I wish I changed the key or...
Yeah. Before we get into number one, here's a question that I've always wanted to know. Do you guys, like, all you big DJs, like, do you guys get together secretly when nobody knows? Like, are you getting, like, you know, is Tiesto and you and maybe David Guetta and all you guys, do you guys all meet up and just go do your own thing, never goes on social?
Yeah, we it's not like we have secret meetups.
No, I know, but like...
What I love about the DJ industry is there's so many friendships and everybody has the same joy, the same passion for music. I think there's zero jealousy.
That's what I was going to say. I feel that from we get to interview a lot of the DJs, and I always feel like every other DJ is complimenting the other DJs. And I thought that's a really cool thing because you don't get that in many industries.
Yeah, but I in general, like whenever I have day off or if I am already the day before at a festival and I am, one of my friends is playing, like, it could be David, could be Fisher, could be Black Coffee, like I'm there.
Yeah.
I'll be so cool. In the crowd with a hoodie or a friend at front of house, like, dancing. And I think it's also good to go see other shows, get inspired, get your excitement.
Yeah.
Because it's cool to be on the stage, but I think it's sometimes even
that is
cooler to be in the crowd and the whole immersive experience.
Hypothetically, if you were in jail, hypothetically, it will never happen. Who's the one DJ that you're calling to get you out? Who will get you out the quickest?
Wow, that's a good question. I've never really thought of this.
No, I know, I know. Like, you've got the one call. They go, Martin, you've got one call to get out. Like, who is it?
Who's
is that?
Who's gonna answer?
Who's connected? Maybe. Who's gonna? You know, they're gonna get you out.
Wow, that's a good question. David Guetta's very connected, and he is the nicest guy. He will always answer his phone. But same goes for Chesto. But then I also think Fisher would bake a cake and deliver it.
He'll get you out another way.
Yeah.
He'll get you out another way.
So with a screwdriver.
Yeah, there's different ways, different ways. Angles.
All right. As we finish off the top five, here is the final song. It can only go in one position, really, which is number one, but here it is. Is it
just Yeah.
You happy with it?
Yeah, I thought it was this or High on Life. And those for me are both shared number one.
So Scared to Be Lonely with, of course, Dua Lipa. Which, I mean, vocally as well with this. And
it's crazy.
It gives you the feels, it gives you everything, right?
It's for me one of the most important songs that I've ever been part of. And also to see what this would do Lipa after. It's amazing. So this song definitely for me on number one.
We've locked it in at number one. Guys, go and see Martin Garrix if you want. Saturday night, it's going to be there. This is a rare opportunity. We get to see him doing what he's doing on this huge stage. He's playing good stuff, old stuff, new stuff. We've heard about it. Tickets go to platinumlist.net. We say this, the three of us, we've been doing this show together for 12 years. We've interviewed David Guetta a number of times, and we always say he's
The nicest
guy, right?
The nicest.
Thank you.
Martin Garrix, you are the nicest guy, man.
Yeah.
Thank you for doing what you did. Thank you for coming into the studio and just thank you for being a gentleman.
No worries. Thank you guys for
having
me. Absolutely. Lots of love. Martin Garrix. Virgin Radio.